With 150 baht, you can explore this much of Bangkok. This section, not many people come.
Don't forget to come and take photos over here.
Everything, the buildings look nice. Front of the Grand Palace, just here,
where you can rent your Thai dress over here.
The real Thai street food experience. To get here, take BTS to Saphan Taksin station. When you reach the station, looking for the sign, say to Sathorn Pier on exit 2. As you can see, it's quite a popular place for tourists to come. Let me explain to you this first. If you notice, this is Chao Phraya Express Boat. There are different lines. If you want to do one stop, you can buy the Express Boat. The Express Boat will be smaller, but what we're going to do today is hop on and hop off tourist boat. The boat will be bigger and drive more slowly and stop early. A main tourist attraction. Chao Phraya Tourist Boat, you have two options, right? A single journey, 30 baht. A day pass would be 150 baht. Our day pass, couple. This is my receipt. It is 150 baht. The boat will come every half an hour. And this is your booklet or passport that you can use getting in the boat. This is a river guide book, quite nice. There are different things that you can do along Chao Phraya rivers. And this is the map of the trip that we're going to do today. Let me try to find a seat and explain to you. We are here, right? Central Pier or Sathorn Pier. We will then go into the river on the right hand side. And they're going to stop at a major pier that have tourist attractions like Wat Pho, Wat Arun, Thapaatip, Grand Palace, and Wat Pagel. This is our boat for today. Chao Phraya Song tourist boat, double deck. And once you get in, you have two options to go on the first floor or a upper floor. In the upper floor, you get to see a much nicer view, but it will be extremely hot and sunny day for you. The first stop is going to be ICONSIAM Pier. Now you're going to get off from this boat. If you notice, there's no any signal or the bell for you to call. If you're going to get out, just make sure you come and stand in the hard section of this ferry so the driver know that they're going to stop at this pier. Otherwise, they just keep going. Let me show you the lower deck first. We are now heading to Lachawong Pier. Our first stop for today is Tha Lachawong. Basically, it's an old Chinese community. You will get to see a little bit of Sampeng, a local market. If you walk a little bit further, that will be Chinatown. Bye bye. Let me show you how the local boat look like. This is a normal express boat, Chao Phraya River. They have different color. This is the orange one. I recommend you to take this boat trip early in the morning because you get to stop at every pier. We have 30 minutes until the next boat arrives, so I will walk you around this Saphan market around 15 minutes. Then we're gonna come back to the boat. From the building, you can see that this is an old community. If you walk further down, you will see Saphan market. This market, you get to experience a real authentic what local people are buying and eating. We just walk from Ratchawong Pier over there to Saphan market. Actually, Saphan is in a little alley on your left hand side over there, and this is another side of Saphan market. You need to walk in. This is one of my favorite, khanom khai. If you have kids, you can buy toys for them over here. They're quite cheap. That is a long tail boat. Sometimes you can rent a long tail boat to go to all the canals, connect to Chao Phraya River. Over there, that is the ferry that gets you across from east side of Chao Phraya River. We finished Ratchawong Pier. We are now going to go to Wat Arun. As you see, right, all people get their cameras because the view is stunning. This is what we call Saphan Put Bridge. The flower market of Pak Khong Talat is over there. If you see the tall pagoda over there, that is Wat Arun. And if you want to get off from this tourist boat, you need to come and standing here so the driver know that you are going to get out. We are now at Wat Arun, or Temple of Dawn. If you see people here, especially ladies, they dress up in Thai style. They're here for the pictures. You can buy your ticket over here. It costs 100 baht. Wat Arun open from 8 in the morning to 6 in the evening, but the ticket they close at 5:30. And one thing is that you have to have a proper dress to come to Wat Arun. Otherwise, you have to rent that salon. This is do and don't at Wat Arun. And there's quote here that you have to cover your knee. If you don't have, you can borrow from her. Actually, this Wat Arun, they kind of have some Chinese influence. If you notice, there will be some Chinese guardian sculpture over here. See all the tourists coming here, they dress in traditional Thai style. Let me take the stair up for you. I think these two should be bride and groom. They may have their pre-wedding photos over here at Wat Arun. You can walk around in the basement. I call this basement because
Actually, there's more stairs for you to climb up. But they just open during some special occasion. There are a lot of good spots for you to take photos. Just be careful on your step downstairs. Just have to be careful on your way back. The pagoda here, this is the main point of interest of Wat Arun. But this is actually Wat Arun. Let me walk you around real quick. Now you get to see Thai monk. Again, I will come back and do a video about Wat Arun. This video is mostly about the tourists hop on and hop off Chao Phraya River tour. So, and don't forget to come to this section where you can have your pictures with a big giant. As you see, this section not many people come. That is the reason why you have to check out my other video and subscribe to my channels. My name is CHON. I know Bangkok and Thailand like the back of my hand. If you're coming to Thailand or Bangkok, I'm sure that I will give you a better information to make your trip to Thailand be a better one. Don't forget to come and take photos over here, like this. This is the main temple where a lot of activities will happen here of Wat Arun. In Thai, we call it Ubosot. For English, I'm not sure. By getting in, you need to take off your shoes. Let me show you what this Ubosot or chapel look like. In the main chapels of every temple, it will be the main Buddha, the biggest Buddha of that temple. You can pay your respect here. Actually, if you want to go to declining Buddha or Wat Pho, you can walk to that pier over there, right? There'll be a ferry if you see far apart there. There'll be a ferry that go to another pier that you can walk to Wat Pho. But now, let me stick to the plan. Let me sit under the shade a little bit because it is a sunny day. Wat Arun over there, right? And this is Ratchanawi Samosorn. Basically, this is a marine military base in Bangkok. On the other side, this is Gan Palace. I just mentioned to you, if you take the ferry to go across from Wat Arun, you can come to this pier and walk to Gan Palace area. The reason why that they closed that pier is because that we are now going to this pier, which is not far from Gan Palace. Just so you know. We are now at Tha Chang Pier. I put this upside down for you, right? Because you can understand easier. We're coming all the way from BTS Saphan Taksin Sathorn Central Pier. We stop here at Wat Arun and we are now at Tha Chang Pier, where I will walk you out the Gan Palace, Wat Pho, and all the things around this pier in a little bit. Because Tha Chang is close by Gan Palace, they just have a big renovation. So on the part, everything's the buildings look nice. With only short walk from the pier, and this is Gan Palace. We have to find the entrance though. The main entrance is over there. Around main attraction in Thailand, there will be a tuk-tuk driver. If you're willing to take tuk-tuk, make sure you know what to deal with them, right? Negotiate the price and do not stop at any of their friend shop. Let me walk you around Tha Phachan real quick. Tha Phachan is like an old neighborhood that they usually sell amulet Buddha
or Pha Khương. In Tha Pha Chan areas, they're famous for Thai traditional herbal products. For tourists, it might be very confusing for you because there's no English, right? No English. But like old Thai people, they still use a lot of herbal related medicine. And don't forget to check out this Mahala Tunnels. It will link you to Gan Palace, Sanam Luang, and San Lak Meung. They just built recently. This is my first time here. One good thing about it is that they got aircon in here. Very nice, clean. And everything. They have small exhibition over here to show you what Gan Palace used to look like. This is a short tunnel. Actually, there are another tunnels. I will show you in a later video. And now you are in front of the Gan Palace. The main entrance is just here. To make this video not so long, let me continue on my route. I will come back and do the Gan Palace video alone later. Let me finish this video right here because I don't want to make it too long. Anyway, please subscribe to the channel. I will edit the second part of Chao Phraya River tourist boat tonight. Be sure to subscribe. My name is CHON. If you're coming to Thailand, this is the channel for you. Hit like to keep me motivated making more video for you. Bye bye for now. Sawasdee krab.